Before the Portuguese discovery of the archipelago of Madeira in the 15th century, knowledge of its existence was known by others and was referenced in a number of different cultures. This video will go over the points in history where references to the archipelago have been made and by who, starting from the ancient era to the 14th century. The Atlantic was considered for a long time the sea of darkness and gloom, unable to be navigated by Mediterranean vessels. The wind and sea currents on the African coast also made it difficult to return from a voyage from there. The first possible sightings of the Atlantic islands may have been done by the Egyptians and the Phoenicians through various expeditions they made that went to the western African coast. The Phoenicians, for example, had gone as far as the West African coast in projecting their commercial empire, also claimed by the defenders of classical culture in the 18th and 19th century. Of the various expeditions made in antiquity, they begin, as far as we know, from the order of Pharaoh Necho II, then followed in 550 BC by Euthymenes, who was a merchant from Marseille, Sataspes, who reached Guinea, and then the tour of Hanno the Navigator, a Carthaginian explorer in 425 BC, with a fleet of 60 ships along the African coast as far as Cape Verde. In the Greco-Roman era, the Atlantic Islands were referenced in historical recounts of possible sightings from those who had sailed in the vicinity of the islands. Some of the references to the Atlantic Islands from the ancient Greco-Roman period include Diodorus, a Greek historian from the 1st century BC of Sicily, in his work titled Bibliotheca Historica, which refers to the discovery in the 5th century BC of an island described by its paradisiacal environment and dense trees. Strabo, a Greek geographer, historian, and philosopher, mentions in 100 BC the discovery of another island that its discoverers were amazed by due to the abundance of water and wood. Lastly, Plutarch, a Greek biographer born in the 1st century BC, around 80 BC, in the narrative of the history of Sertorius, a Roman general and statesman who led a large-scale rebellion against the Roman Senate on the Iberian Peninsula, tells us that when he was pursued by the Romans, he took refuge on an island in the Atlantic. At the start of the 3rd century, there were no more references to the Atlantic Islands. Recorded expeditions from then on were very scarce. As the centuries went by, one possible visit to Madeira could have been made by the Vikings. Despite there being no historical references of Vikings travelling to Madeira, due to recent archaeological findings from surveys done in Punta de São Lourenço in Madeira, a probable theory of a Viking visit to Madeira was created. From those surveys, bones of mice were found that were carbon dated to at least before the year 1036, 4 centuries before the Portuguese settlement of Madeira. Genetic study of the current mouse populations of Madeira shows similarities with those of Scandinavia and northern Germany, and it has been reported that Vikings would transport house mice to the places they reached. These mice that may have reached Madeira from a Viking ship could have easily multiplied due to their high reproductive potential and due to the fact there were no rats on Madeira, which could have limited their numbers. However, these new findings suggests, but not prove, a relationship between the Viking voyages and the presence of mice on Madeira, as due to widespread trade routes and various ventures that were certainly made by seafarers close to the Atlantic Islands, mouse from Scandinavia could easily have boarded a ship that reached Portugal to then be transported to Madeira by another group of mariners. The few voyages to the islands that happened after, and slowly as time progressed into and through the Middle Ages, were done by Arab sailors who documented an oceanic space sprinkled with islands. Muhammad al-Idrisi, who was an Arab geographer in the 12th century, describes in his work Kitab Nushat al-Mushtaq, which was a compendium of geographical information, that a certain expedition took place from Lisbon in 1147, where two adventurers reached an island on their way back from their voyage that took them to an area of sticky and stinking waters, which may have been the Sargasso Sea in the Atlantic, close to Bermuda, that became known as the Cattle Islands due to the presence of sheep. This island that they reached from their return may have been Madeira or the Azores, but also the island of El Hierro of the Canary Islands due to the sheep. After this expedition, there followed others that reached the Atlantic Islands, such as Ibn Fatima and Mohammed ben Ragano. After the Arab expeditions to the Atlantic Islands, the Arabs then bequeathed the Atlantic navigational tradition over to the Portuguese and others, including expeditions that were under the commands of Italians, Bretons, Basques, Normans and Catalans, and more. There was a significant increase in frequency of expeditions to the Atlantic Islands in the 14th century, especially to the Canary Islands, in a vast maritime area which stretches out some 300 to 400 kilometers from the western end of the Straits of Gibraltar, extending between the latitudes of Cape St. Vincent and the Canaries, which was an area frequently referred to as the Gulf or Valley of the Mares. Because of this, knowledge of the Madeiran archipelago existed before its formal discovery and settlement and its recognition in Portuguese cartography. It's from the middle of the 14th century that the islands first appear, but in imperfect form and with Latin names. We start with the Vivaldi's brothers expedition in 1291 that got the ball rolling. After them, more expeditions followed, with voyages made by the Matelots of Cherbourg sometime shortly before 1312, the expedition of Lancelotto de Malocello in the service of the King of Portugal around 1310, and Angiolino d'Alteghe de Curbizzi and Nicoloso de Recco's expedition in June 1341. The Portuguese expeditions in this period were likely helped by Manuel Pessanha, a Genoese merchant and sea captain who was hired in 1317 by King Dinis to create the Royal Fleet and to prepare the Portuguese sailors in the necessary knowledge of the art of sailing. However, the knowledge of navigational science was likely very advanced in Portugal by the time Manuel arrived. In fact, in the book about the Jean de Betancourt expedition to the Canaries in 1402, the authors refer to Portugal, Spain, and Aragon as having pilots who knew the ports and these regions. In the Atlantic Ocean, the Iberian pilots slowly learned new methods of navigation. Meanwhile, the Mediterranean pilots continued to follow their usual rules. There seems little reason to doubt that the nation that contributed most to the discovery of the Atlantic Ocean was Portugal. Returning to the expeditions, the subsequent cartographical representation of the Atlantic Islands would come as a result of these expeditions. In regards to nautical charts, from 1339, with the chart of Angelino Dorset, the first representation of the Madeiran Islands was presented, under the names of Insilia Capraria for Madeira, Primaria for Porto Santo, and Canaria for the deserted islands. But there are some who dispute whether this chart was the first to represent Madeira, and that it represents Madeira at all. If the Dorset chart of 1339, despite registering some of the Canaries, still does not represent the Madeira Islands, although some claim they do, the islands do appear shortly after, in 1351, on a chart from the so-called Medici Atlas. It was here with the Medici Atlas where the cartographic representation of the archipelago was first identified with their modern names, between 1351 and 1357. The Medici Atlas may have benefited from the 1341 mapping expedition to the Canary Islands sponsored by King Afonso IV of Portugal and commanded by Angelino d'Alteghe de Corbizzi from Florence and Nicolozzo de Recco from Genoa. The Savage Island group appears for the first time in the chart of Abraham Gresques in 1375. Madeira is represented graphically in all known charts in the same way from 1325 to 1379, with slight modifications in the contours and relative positions of the islands from chart to chart. It was the chart of Messia de Valladestes in 1413 in which the design of Madeira comes close to its real configuration for the first time. In regard to the naming of the archipelago, there were very slight alterations in the spelling of Madeira and the Savage Islands. As far as the deserted islands and Porto Santo are concerned, they were always indicated by their respective names, with only the very slightest orthographic variation. The islands and their actual names can be seen for the first time for Porto Santo, Savage Islands, and the deserted islands in 1370, with Porto Santo receiving its name spelt exactly as it is now around 1384 in the Atlas of Pinelli Walkenauer, and in 1408 Madeira was seen with its name as it is today, and it was in 1424 in the Pizzigano chart that it had its exact spelling. To conclude, a number of groups of people have set their eyes upon Madeira and have referenced the archipelago in their respective cultures, from ancient myth of Atlantis to likely sightings by peoples as early as the Egyptians and Phoenicians, to being a possible stopping point for Vikings and sightings by Arabs. But by the turn of the 14th century, there would be an explosion of expeditions to the Atlantic that acquainted a number of new groups of people to the islands of Madeira.